guys. So today's video I'm super excited about, and I know some of you have been waiting for this video for a very long time. So as you all know, Kim Kardashian has launched her new contour kit, I guess it is, contour sticks. And she has a whole beauty line that she's supposedly coming out with. So her first product was contour sticks. I wanted to give this a try because, I mean, it's Kim Kardashian, it's KKW Beauty, and I'm sure everyone is wondering what it's like. I do want to say that I already have foundation on my face. I already did my eyes. They're not completely finished, but I pretty much did everything that I would normally do. So I really wanted to put these to the test and actually test them out and use them the way I would normally use them. So I'm going to show you how this came. The first thing that I received is this bag. So it all came in this bag like this, which is really cute. I know this sounds really crazy, but I kind of want to frame this and put it up. I just love the color. It goes with the theme of my makeup room. So that is what I think I'm going to do. I just really like the color. Then it came with this little card, and it kind of explains what everything's for. So it tells you how to prep, how to contour, what to use a matte highlight for, and what to use a shimmer highlight for. It also says that she has a few things coming up for KKW Beauty. So yeah. And then the products, of course. I bought mine in the color dark. I did that because I saw that she was using the medium and the dark, and I'm way darker than she is, so I figured that the dark would be perfect. But now, after seeing so many people use it, I think I should have gotten the really dark one, the last one. But we're gonna just try this one out and see what happens. Even if it's a light contour, I just am trying out the actual product itself, so color isn't really a factor into my decision right now. So I just want to let you guys know that. So we're gonna try this out. So it comes with the brush. So the brush is actually really, really soft, and I think it's gonna be good for blending out. I'm kind of excited to try this brush. And then the sponge doesn't really feel like something I would normally use. It's kind of like, it feels like those sponges that are like those cheap sponges that are wannabe beauty blenders, you know. So I don't know if I'm really gonna like the sponge, so I have my sponge just in case. And I also have a little bit of Fix Plus just in case I need it to test this out. So yeah, and then I also wanted to mention to you guys that I haven't watched any reviews because I wanted to form my own opinion. So I've really been dying because I really want to know if this stuff works. So I'm actually excited to watch this so I can watch other people's reviews, because they look really good, and I just really didn't want to alter my opinion because this is very important to some of you. I know a lot of you have been requesting this, and I really wanted to give you my honest opinion. So with that said, we're gonna get started. So first and foremost, let's start off with the contour. So it says right here, it's the dark contour. There's only 0.32 ounces per side. So this is what it looks like. I'm gonna actually, I don't, literally, you guys, this is all the product there is. It does not go up more than this. I also want to mention that this product was $56 with tax. I'm a little disappointed in this, but maybe a little bit goes a long way, so let's just try it because I'm really annoyed. Like, I usually contour every day, so this will be gone in like 2 weeks. Okay, so we're gonna try this. So I guess one side is, so it says 1 and 2. One side is definitely darker than the other side. So this is a darker side, this is a lighter side. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the lighter side. I'm really annoyed that this is like all of that. Okay, whatever. So I'm gonna go ahead. Okay, so it feels super, super creamy. Also, for those of you who don't know, I have oily skin. Well, it's like combination oily, but right now it's like super oily. Okay, so that's what I'm using for my nose. Kind of looks like the same color as my skin, maybe like a tad bit darker. Now I'm using the darker side, and you guys, these are honestly a little bit might go a long way. These are super creamy. Oh. just broke. Okay, so make sure you're using it like really small because it will break off. Okay, well that was annoying, so whatever. Okay, so I'm just putting this all over my face. They are super creamy, so a little bit will go a long way, but I still feel like I won't have any left in the next few days, and I'm not paying $56 over and over again for this product. That's how I feel right now. I'm gonna go ahead and take the brush, and I'm going to use the brush side first and blend this out. Okay, so it's not terrible. It does blend out really nice. I can say that. Like, I don't have to tug on my skin to blend it out, which I love. I think the color actually works out pretty good. It's definitely more of a subtle contour, like a natural one. I actually kind of like that. Guys, I'm not gonna lie, it looks so natural, but I kind of like it. Like, you can still see the difference. Okay, I'm liking this so far. The brush is actually not bad at all. I wish it just came just the brush, because I think I like this brush. All right. So, I don't hate it. I don't hate it. Okay. So now we're gonna go in with the highlight side. So I'm gonna use the matte side, which again, it's the same amount of product, which is terrible. I don't know why she thought this was a good idea. This is like not enough. Anyway, I'm gonna apply this to anywhere I would normally highlight. I know she said you can use this as a concealer, or you can use it like underneath your concealer, which is probably what I'm gonna do, because I honestly don't think this is brightening enough to just use as a concealer. So with this, I'm gonna use the same brush. It's not terrible. Okay. So I'm not sure if you guys can see this, but in this area, I feel like it's like dry. Like it's breaking apart, if you know what I mean. Which I don't know if I like that. Okay, I'm gonna try the sponge. So I'm wetting it with a little bit of Fix Plus because I can already tell that this product is dry. I just want to show you guys because this is fucking crazy. Okay, this took off my foundation. So I don't know what to do now because I don't want to start my... What the hell? Okay. I don't like this at all. Guys, I honestly don't know what to do. I feel like I hate this. I'm gonna try with this brush and see. Okay, so with this brush it blends out a little bit better. Let's try the shimmer side. I'm already annoyed with this product, I'm not gonna lie. So I can already tell that I don't like this color highlights because it's too dark for... Okay, I'm not even gonna go forward with this because the highlight is way too dark for my skin color. I usually go for more like gold highlights, and this is a bronzy highlight, so this is what it looks like. So I'm actually gonna put it on my hand so you can see. So it does look nice, but I feel like it's not really the type of highlight that I would normally use, if that makes any sense. And it doesn't really do much for me, to be 100% honest with you. So the highlighting stick. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some concealer to this and see how it worked on top of the matte highlight. I'm going to go ahead and take my Tarte concealer because as you guys can see, this is not enough for every day. She claims that she uses this every day, like even when she doesn't have a full face of makeup on. I'm going to say I highly doubt that because there's no coverage, and I know Kim Kardashian has super dark circles, so there's no way she's just using this matte highlighting stick to conceal. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and apply some of this concealer. So I have a damp beauty blender sponge thing. This one's from L'Oreal. And I'm just gonna go ahead and blend this out. So I do wanna mention that normally when I do this, it never looks dry. This concealer is literally my go-to concealer, and I never have an issue with this concealer. So, if it does end up looking dry, I can guarantee you 100% it's not this concealer, it's the one that I used before. It actually does not look terrible, so you can wear the matte highlighting stick underneath your regular concealer if that's what you want to do to make it a little bit brighter. I definitely think it helped brighten the area a little bit because sometimes you can see a little bit of darkness peeking through with my makeup, my under eye area. So it definitely helped a little bit. Would I add this into my everyday routine? Probably not. So this is what everything looks like. I'm gonna zoom you in. This is what my skin looks like after all the products. This is with, as you can see, the contour stick. This is a very light contour. I could have went darker. I could have added a darker powder to this to make it super duper contoured. But I wanted to keep it light so I can really see if the product stands out, which it does. Like if I move my head around, you can definitely see. My nose is kind of contoured. I haven't mastered the nose contour just yet. My skin doesn't look super powdery or anything, which is a good thing. Because sometimes it looks super muddy, which this product I can say does not look muddy. So overall I think I like it. I'm gonna finish my makeup because I was in the middle of doing it, and then I'm gonna come back and talk about my final thoughts. Okay guys, so I am back to give you my final thoughts on these three products that came in one. So first and foremost, I do want to say that the price is outrageous. I do not think that people should be buying this for $56 with shipping. The shipping alone was $8.95, which I think is a little bit ridiculous. Another thing that I don't really like about Kylie Cosmetics, KKW Beauty, all these brands that do these like restocks or like put things out little by little, it's really annoying for those who really like the product, really love makeup, and would actually rebuy this, because you have to just wait until they restock, and if you get it then you get it, and if you don't, you don't, which is really annoying, especially if you run out of it. It's not like this product has a lot of products in it, so it's gonna run out really fast. And what sucks about that is that then you just have to wait for the next restock, which who knows when the next restock is gonna be. So that's my first point on the overall product as a whole and the company as a whole. Also, I think that contour sticks are a little played out at this point. You can really contour with anything at this point. Any bronzer, any foundation that's a darker color, anything like that you can use to contour. So actually buying a contour stick is a little pointless at this point in the makeup game. So that is my own opinion. I've been doing makeup for years now. I've been on YouTube for a few years now, and I just feel like at this point in time, it's kind of redundant having like another contour product. As for the product itself, I definitely feel like she gypped all of us on the amount of product that we get. Like there's no way that this amount of product is going to ever last me more than a month, even if you don't use it every day. I use this every single day. So if I'm using this every single day, by the end of the month, I'm not gonna have any of this. And I'm not spending $56 for a whole entire kit just so I can use a contour. Which brings me to my next point. I definitely think that she shouldn't sell them as kits, and she should sell everything individually. And then from there, if you just wanna buy the contour, if you just wanna buy the highlight, if you just wanna buy the brushes, you have that option to do that. I'm sure in the future she will have that. I just feel like you should just start out that way, because not everyone wants to highlight. Maybe some people just want to contour, you know what I mean? And for me, I find highlighting a little bit easier with my concealer. So that's usually just what I use to highlight. There's nothing special about my highlighting routine. I have a whole entire face routine that I did a few months ago, and I explain everything thoroughly, how I contour, highlight, all that good stuff. I will link that video below so that you guys can go watch it if you want. But yeah, so that's my overall on the product itself. So now I'm gonna go individually. The contour stick I think actually did work. If the price wasn't ridiculous, I would definitely say I would use this again. I love how it blended out. It blended out so nicely. It went on super easy. I didn't have to tug on my skin. The consistency of it was very creamy but satiny, and it felt a little bit more hydrating than most things that I use to contour, which I really liked that about this product. product. Super easy to use. The lighter side didn't make much of a difference. I could use either side, it doesn't really matter. The darker side was actually the right color. I think if I used the other color, which is deep dark, if I used that one, I would have a more intense highlight, or sorry, a more intense contour. But since I wanted something a little bit more on the natural side, I think this actually worked out perfectly. As you can see, it looks super blended out. It looks really, really nice. I actually really do like the consistency of the contour. I do like it. I just, again, the price is what steered me away. But the product itself, I really do have to say that the contour really blew my mind. I didn't expect it to blend out that way. I didn't expect to actually see a difference in my skin when I applied the product. So that's what I can say about the contour. I think that she could have worked a little bit better on the shade range. The highlight for the dark complexion kit, I don't really like. I feel like that highlight is better off for someone a little bit darker than me. I never use highlights like that. I always use gold or even a little bit more pearly. This was like a bronze. I don't know, like it looks more like a lipstick, honestly. Like I'm pretty sure MAC has a lipstick called O or Zero, and it's the exact same color. So as for the highlight, I'm not using that highlight. The matte highlight was horrible, as you guys can see. I couldn't really blend it out. It was very dry. It didn't blend out as easily as the contour did. So I was a little bit disappointed, but I can say that if you want to use just a little bit to maybe counteract the darkness, if you have a lot of dark circles, you can use that together with your concealer. I did like the effect that that had. Will I use it every day and add it to my everyday routine? Probably not. I'll probably use it if I'm filming and just want that extra like coverage. But I'm not gonna add that to my routine. I felt like it was super dry. I did like how it looked afterwards. Like it definitely didn't cake up on me. It didn't look crazy. When I added powder to it, it was perfectly fine. It didn't get, like it didn't come apart. Sometimes when things are a little bit too dry, they kind of come apart if you add like something damp to it or if you add powder to it. This didn't happen with this product, which I was very surprised by because of how dry it was. The color was perfect though. The color for the highlight, the matte highlight, was perfect for my skin tone. I think it worked really, really nice. I just wish it was a little bit creamier and maybe a little more like a concealer, I guess. Because it really wasn't a concealer. It was more of just what it is, like a highlight, I guess. You just put it on top or below your concealer. So I just feel like that's an extra step that most people aren't willing to take. So it's a little bit pointless. So again, not my favorite product. I probably won't be using it ever again. As for the brush, I'm not even gonna talk about the sponge because this is just like an embarrassment. Like, why would you put this? Like, what is this? There's no squishiness to it. I even tried it with water and it just didn't absorb anything. It didn't do anything. I don't like the sponge. I feel like if I'm paying $56, you better put your all into a sponge, into everything that I'm getting, and that's kind of offensive. So I don't like that. The brush, on the other hand, was super, super soft. I absolutely love the brush. I wish it came like larger, like a regular brush, because I would definitely use this to blend out my contour. I loved the way it blended it out. It does shed a tiny, tiny bit. I did notice that, but I really do like this. And I believe these brushes pop out. They do. So these brushes actually pop out. And if I'm correct, she's coming out with more brush heads so that you can just buy the brush head and keep the little tube, and that way you can just kind of snap it in, which is cool. I would be willing to try her other brushes if they look like this and feel like this, because I did really enjoy this brush. So the brush for me is a yes, the sponge is a no. If the brush came like a regular brush with just the contour, I would totally purchase that if the price was reasonable. I just can't get over this price, you guys. $56 is ridiculous. Like, I don't even pay that much for a concealer. Like, I don't know. I just feel like it's a lot. Like, not even my foundations cost $56. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a lot. I paid it because I really wanted to test it out. I really wanted to review it for you guys. So that is why I paid it. But honestly, I'm a little frustrated and annoyed that I paid $56 for this, because it's not really worth $56. That is my opinion. I really don't think you should spend your money on this. I feel like you can contour with anything. I do really like the contour. I can say that. If she were to ever just sell the contour stick by itself and it was a good $15, maybe $20, maybe I would spend the money if I didn't have to pay shipping for it. I know I sound so cheap, I know. But honestly, I just don't think it's worth that much. You don't get that much product in it, so it's not like you're getting a whole tube full of contour stick. You know what I mean? Like, it's a tiny, tiny bit. So in my humble opinion, you definitely do not need this product. If you want to support her, go ahead and support her. If you want to just try it on your own, by all means, do it. But if you're looking for an honest opinion, it's just not worth it to me. This isn't a great product for me, guys. And that is the truth. So I am very excited to see what else she comes out with. I definitely will, you know, try things out and see if you guys want to see more of her stuff when she does come out with it. Let me know and I will definitely test it out for you guys. I'm not afraid to try new things, even if they are super duper expensive. But I do like testing them and I like telling you guys what the deal is with everything. So I definitely don't mind purchasing stuff as she releases them. So yeah, so that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and leave me any comments you have below. And thank you so much for watching. If you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel so you can join my YouTube family. And make sure you give this video a thumbs up if you like my reviews and want to see more on other products. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.